I'm Bogdan, and today I'll speak about the ways to apply convolutions to solve PDEs using data-driven models. These are my collaborators and the group. So PDEs, as probably all of you know, describe all around us, from fluids and hyperelastic materials to climate modeling, weather forecast, etc. One of the core examples are Navier-Stokes equations, and our goal is to approximate solution operators of PDEs. For example, it could be to predict weather tomorrow, given a weather today. One more example is given a fluid and the input vorticity of a fluid, we could predict the output vorticity or vorticity at fixed point in time, for example, in 2 seconds or some fixed time. And the ultimate goal is to construct data-driven models, because we have usually large amount of data, for example, in weather forecast. The goal is to construct data-driven surrogate models for solution operators of PDEs, where the data is obtained either from observations or simulations. And we want to have some characteristics of our models. That is, our models need to consider the inputs and outputs as functions in some discrete representation on some meshes. And they need to generalize under different meshes, because for a given continuous function, we can have a lot of discrete representations, so a lot of samples, but there is only one true continuous function that we want to learn. And the models that have the characteristics that I have just described are called neural operators. In our case, they're purely data-driven. They could also be physics-informed, but in our case, they're purely data-driven, and they solve the or approximate PDEs for many instances of input functions. They're possibly slow to train, but very fast to evaluate, which gives them advantage over the numerical methods that are used for many centuries now. There comes our convolutional neural operator. So first, in this operator learning community, people didn't use too much the convolutions, because they are scale dependent and cause aliasing errors, which we can discuss in the break. But they're also very efficient in many image processing tasks, as we all know. So the question is, could we adapt standard CNNs to learn operators? And in fact, we can, and that's what we have shown in our paper. We use this UNet-like architecture, but we changed all the fundamental operations in the UNet to account for the fact that we learn operators and we deal with function spaces and not just the Euclidean data. So we adapted the downsampling and upsampling block. We also adapted the activation layers. And for example, how we adapted the activation operator is we don't apply it locally or point-wise anymore, but we apply it in 3 stages. So the first stage, we upsample our signal. Then we apply the operator, the activation point-wise in the usual way, and then we downsample the function back to the physical space. And why is that important? In this way, we reduce the aliasing error, or actually, we show that we almost eliminate the aliasing errors that appear when we apply the activation operator. In a similar manner, we modify the upsampling and the downsampling operator. And in this way, we get the convolutional neural operator, which now accounts for the fact that we deal with function spaces. And I'll show just some results. We applied the CNO to many different benchmarks, from Poisson wave equation to different fluid flows and compressible oil equations, and we see that we found a very strong benchmark. And maybe the conclusion is that we're really able to learn different natural phenomena modeled by the PDEs. Some references, and thank you.